Everyone, so in the last few classes we were discussing about measures of dispersion, correct na? So measures of dispersion means the measures with which we are calculating dispersion. Dispersion means scattering of observations from their central value, isn't it? See, we saw three measures, which and all range, quartile deviation and mean deviation. So compared to the first two, mean deviation is a better measure of dispersion, isn't it? Range depends on only extreme values. Then second one, quartile deviation ignores 50% of observations. Even though compared to that two, mean deviation is the best one, isn't it? But mean deviation has got its own limitations. First demerit of mean deviation is, even though it is based on all the observations and even though it takes into consideration we are measuring a deviation from central value, it has got its own limitation. The main demerit means here we are ignoring the sign. So algebraic signs from which we are taking the deviations, that sign we are ignoring here. We are taking only absolute value. So that is one of the demerit of this mean deviation. So to overcome that demerit, the fourth measure of dispersion was introduced by Carl Pearson, one mathematician. His name is Carl Pearson. I'll write here. So Carl Pearson introduced. Carl Pearson introduced this measure of dispersion, that is standard deviation. It is very familiar to you because you already studied in your 10th standard standard deviation, isn't it? This is the best measure of dispersion also. Compared to central tendency, in central tendency which and all five measures we saw, mean, median, mode, then harmonic mean and geometric mean, which is the best measure of central tendency, do you remember? Yes, mean is the arithmetic mean is the best measure of central tendency because it satisfies almost all the properties of a good measure of central tendency. Similarly, here in measures of dispersion, also we saw a good measure of dispersion is in such a way that it must takes into consideration some properties. If that properties are satisfied by a almost properties, we can't say that all the properties it will satisfy, but most of the properties will be satisfied by this standard deviation. So standard deviation is considered to be the best measure of dispersion. Okay. Next, this one, standard deviation. What is this standard deviation? See, in mean deviation we ignore the sign. Instead of that ignoring the sign, what we are doing here is, here we are taking deviations from arithmetic mean itself, but we are squaring that deviation. So it is called standard deviation. We are squaring that deviation to ignore the sign. So some sign may be negative. So negative and positive madlike here we are not taking the absolute deviation. Instead we are squaring that deviations. So what is the definition? First we will see standard deviation definition. Standard deviation is, it is defined as the positive square root of the mean of the squared deviations of given observations from their arithmetic mean. See, this is the simplest one. It is the positive square root. Positive square root. See, one number has got two square roots, isn't it? 49. Square root of 49 is minus 7 as well as plus 7. Minus 7 into minus 7 or negative 7 into negative 7, we will get a positive 49. Similarly, plus 7 into plus 7, we will get a 49. Correct now? So, same here. But here, which number we are taking? Positive. It is the positive square root of the arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean means something of the form sigma divided by n. So sigma divided by, sigma means total, total number divided by small n number of observation. It is the positive square root of the arithmetic mean of the square of the deviations, square of the deviations of the observations from their arithmetic mean. Deviations, we are x minus x bar is called this deviation. Deviation we are taking from which one? X bar itself, arithmetic mean itself we are taking the deviation. So x minus x bar itself, we are squaring this deviation, remember. So squaring this deviation, then we are taking the square root of that one. So it is the positive square root of this itself, I wrote in terms of sentence. So that is a definition. So definition of a standard deviation is, it is the arithmetic mean of square of the standard, square of the arithmetic mean. It is the positive square root of the arithmetic mean of the square of the deviations from their arithmetic mean, isn't it? So here also we are taking deviation from arithmetic mean itself, that deviations we are squaring, then taking its arithmetic mean, then taking its square root. That is our standard deviation. The best measure of dispersion, which was introduced by Carl Pearson in 1893, he introduced this standard deviation. Then it's a like all measures of dispersion, it has a coefficient, it has got a coefficient or relative measure. Relative measure of standard deviation is, it is coefficient of standard deviation. Coefficient of standard deviation is sigma divided by x bar. See, remember, this standard deviation is denoted by this sigma. This is capital sigma, this is small sigma. We pronounce it as sigma. So sigma means this one, sigma, it is denoted by this small sigma. Capital sigma means total. This small sigma means this the we are denoting this standard deviation as a sigma, isn't it? So next, coefficient of standard deviation is sigma, standard deviation divided by x bar. That is relative measure of which one? Standard deviation. Relative measure of standard deviation is a coefficient of variation also, okay. Coefficient of variation is a coefficient of variation equal to sigma divided by x bar into 100. This is a CV or a coefficient of variation. So for comparing coefficient, comparing the variations of a two or more series, which measure of dispersion we are using? We are using coefficient of variation. So coefficient of variation is sigma divided by x bar into 100. So sigma divided by x bar into 100. Sigma means a standard deviation, x bar means a arithmetic mean, into 100 we are expressing in terms of percentage. So percentage, so it is into 100. That is the relative measure of standard deviation, that is coefficient of variation. So standard deviation means what? Standard deviation is first introduced by Carl Pearson. This is the best measure of dispersion. We will see what and all properties it will satisfy, so that why it is called best measure, we will see. Next, it is defined as the positive square root of arithmetic mean of square of the observations from their arithmetic mean. So it is a square root of sigma x minus x bar the whole square divided by small n. N denote number of observations, x bar denote the arithmetic mean. Okay, clear na? Yes. Next, we will go to the properties. See, calculation part I will tell. Calculation, which one? Raw data. How to compute standard deviation in the case of raw data, in case of discrete, in the case of a continuous, we will see. So before that, we will see the properties. Okay, properties of arithmetic, properties of standard deviation. Properties of standard deviation first. See, first property of standard deviation is, for any set of values, sigma is always greater than 0. That one thing you have to remember, standard deviation is always positive. In the definition part itself I told, so standard deviation is the positive square root, so it won't be negative. If your answer is it came as negative, you will conclude that, you can conclude that your answer is wrong. So standard deviation is always a positive. So it is the, for any set of values, sigma greater than 0. So standard deviation is always positive. If it is 0 means what? 0 means there is no standard deviation or there is no variation in the series. So one thing you have to remember, standard deviation is always positive. Standard deviation is always positive, it won't be negative. Second property is standard deviation is independent of change of origin but depends on scale. So what is this independent of origin, depends on scale? You know, in the case of arithmetic mean, I think, see, I'll explain. See, this is the series x1, one series is there, x1, x2, x3, x4, four observations are there. With the respective frequency also we will see, no problem. I'll took this one. See, standard deviation is independent of change of origin, means we are computing the standard deviation of this one. So standard deviation of this one is, first I have to compute arithmetic mean, then apply the formula sigma equal to square root of sigma x minus x bar the whole square divided by n, isn't it? So this one, so I got the answer as, here numbers are there, you think numbers are there, I got the answer as 5. Next, in for the same series, I am adding a constant x1 plus 5 or 6 or any number you are adding, x1 plus c, x2 plus c, x3 plus c, x4 plus c, means the same number I am adding. Then I am computing the standard deviation, means standard deviation won't differ. If I add the series or if I add a constant number to that series and then again I am computing the standard deviation, means the standard deviation won't change. That is the thing that they told, it is independent of origin. Origin means we can, this is the origin. So origin anno ondu number ige add madidru, same number if I add, means standard deviation doesn't change. Next again I am calculating the standard deviation, means I'll get the value as standard deviation as 5 itself. That is the meaning of this one. Standard deviation is independent of origin but depends on scale. See here, but depends on scale means what? Scale means into madidre. See here we saw both standard deviations are same, isn't it? But if I multiply this series, suppose here standard deviation is 5, x1, x2, x3, x4 standard deviation is 5, means next what I am doing is x1 into c, x2 into c, x3 into c, x4 into c. I am multiplying all the numbers by a constant, means here standard deviation won't be 5. This standard deviation won't be 5, means here it changes. So it depends on a scale. Standard deviation is independent of origin. Origin we can shift to any place, but standard deviation depends on a scale. Scale annodu depend agi irtade. So standard into madidre, next if I compute standard deviation, means standard deviation won't be same. Standard deviation changes. So that is the thing. Third one is, it is the least of all root mean square deviations. It is the, we saw in the case of mean deviation is least when it is measured from a median. That is called the minimal property of a median, isn't it? Here it is, this is the least of all root mean square deviation. This root mean square deviation means this one. So this root mean square deviation I can compute from, here it is arithmetic mean, means it is called sigma. If it is, I can take for a median. Median and nan calculate madabodu, square maadi divide. Similarly, I can compute for a mode also. But which one is least? Alright, this is not a sigma, this is something else. Here one more thing, square root of sigma x minus z. Z means mode divided by n. So if I take it is from arithmetic mean, median and mode, which one will be least? Yes, it is least when it is measured from arithmetic mean. If it is measured from arithmetic mean, means it is called standard deviation. So standard deviation is the least of all root mean square deviations. suppose here I got the value as a 8, here I can get a 10. ಇದು ಯಾವತ್ತು ಕೂಡ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 12 ಅಂತ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 8 ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ರೂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ರಿಮೆಂಬ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ನಾ ಎಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಅರಿಥ್ಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾರಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ is independent of origin but it depends on scale remember standard deviation depends on scale but independent of origin third one it is the least of it is the smallest of all root mean square deviations if I take deviations from median mode and arithmetic mean the deviation is least when it is measured from arithmetic mean so it is the least of all root mean square deviations last property is combined standard deviation combined if two series are there first series and second series we can compute the combined standard deviation see in the case of arithmetic mean we saw if two series are there means we can compute the combined arithmetic mean isn't it in the similar manner we can compute combined standard deviation okay combined standard deviation formula is see I'll write here see first one suppose first here series 1 here series 2 first series has n1 number of observations and second series got n2 number of observations and suppose sigma 1 is the standard deviation of first series sigma 2 is the standard deviation of second series and d1 equal to x1 bar minus x bar where x1 bar is the arithmetic mean of the first series x bar is the combined arithmetic mean combined arithmetic mean formula hope you remember xc bar there we saw xc bar equal to n1 x1 bar plus n2 x2 bar divided by n1 plus n2 in the same manner we are xc bar antlu baribodu no problem so x1 bar minus xc bar is our d1 d2 is x2 bar minus xc bar this is our d2 means then the combined standard deviation if I know this much things I can compute the combined standard deviation combined standard deviation is sigma equal to square root of n1 into sigma 1 square plus d1 square plus n2 into sigma 2 square plus d2 square divided by n1 plus n2 this is combined standard deviation formula so combined standard deviation is this one combined standard deviation is n1 into it is sigma or sigma c we can denote as you wish n1 into sigma 1 square plus d1 square plus n2 into sigma 2 square plus d2 square divided by n1 plus n2 where sigma 1 square is a first standard deviation square this is second standard deviation d1 means x1 bar minus xc bar d2 equal to x2 bar minus xc bar divided by n1 plus n2 n1 denote number of observations in the first series n2 denote number of observations in the second series clear na yes next yes only that are the properties of standard deviation one thing I forgot to tell see square of standard deviation is called variance square of standard deviation is called variance I'll write so combined combined arithmetic mean we can compute combined standard deviation so square of standard deviation is called square of standard deviation is called variance so you have to remember this one because in the coming few classes we are discussing this variance also a measure of a good measure of dispersion variance means it is a square of standard deviation I told it is a positive square root isn't it this is a variance means it's a square, standard deviation square is called a variance. So it is denoted by if sigma is a standard deviation means sigma square is our variance. Variance equal to sigma square. Variance equal to sigma square. Sigma square means standard deviation, how much you are getting the answer, it's just a square. 7 you got, suppose standard deviation is 7 means variance equal to 7 square 49. If it is 8 means 8 square 64, that is our variance. Okay, hope this much is clear to you. Next, merits and demerits. After that we will go to, once merits and demerits over, we will go to computation of standard deviation in the case of raw data, discrete series and continuous series. Okay, first one, see merits. Merits means first merit. See here, in the case of mean deviation, mean deviation also it is a merit. The merit of mean deviation is it is based on all the observations we saw, isn't it? Here we are computing x bar there, isn't it? Same here, here it is based on all the observations. See, this is the formula in the case of raw data, sigma x minus x bar the whole square divided by n. So x minus x bar, each x I am taking into consideration. Next we are computing x bar. So x minus x bar we are computing for each observation, then we are going to its square. So it is based on all observations. Standard deviation is based on all observation. It is one merit of standard deviation. Second one, it possesses sampling stability. So I told in a population, suppose 100 items are there in the population, I can extract so many samples. Suppose 50 samples I took from this population, or 50 observations taking as a sample. 50 sample tegda kudle, e 50 sample igu nanu standard deviation calculate martene, sigma 1 second series ige sigma 2 sigma 3 like that, sigma 50 means 50 sample igu I am taking this standard deviation, means it won't differ much. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ಗೂ ತುಂಬ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೆಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೇಪೇಬಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್. ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಿವಿ, ಸಿವಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಮೆಜರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್, ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ ಸಿಗ್ಮಾ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಾರ್ ಇಂಟು 100 ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್. So it is capable of further mathematical treatment. So if I find this one means I can compare the variations of a two or more series, isn't it? So it is capable of further mathematical treatment. It is capable of further mathematical treatment. Next, fourth one, it is well defined by a mathematical formula, isn't it? It is well defined by a mathematical formula. It has got a good mathematical formula. Next, demerits. Even though standard deviation has got its own merits, so what and all demerits are there for arithmetic mean, seen here comes, because we are taking deviations from arithmetic mean here. See here, first demerit means it is difficult to compute. So in the case of arithmetic mean, we can't say it is much difficult, but this is difficult to compute because so many calculations are there, we are taking deviations, next we have to square the deviations. In the case of continuous series, three methods are there. One direct method, next shortcut method, and next step deviation method. So three methods are there to compute standard deviation. So the calculation is bit lengthier and time consuming. So it is bit difficult to compute. Standard deviation is bit difficult to compute. Then one more demerit means it is affected by extreme values. That is also one demerit of standard deviation, because here we are taking deviation from arithmetic mean. In for arithmetic mean also same demerit was there, do you remember? Yes. So it is affected by extreme values. Extreme values are there, means we can't compute arithmetic mean. If you can't compute arithmetic mean, means we can't compute standard deviation also, isn't it? So that are the merits and the demerits of a standard deviation. Merits means it is based on all observations. Second one, it possesses sampling stability. Third one, capable of further mathematical treatment. So standard deviation median or mode na hagala, median matu mode find out madidre next it won't be capable of further mathematical treatment, but arithmetic mean, standard deviation and all we can compute for further mathematical treatment, because in the analysis part, however, variation I have to compare variations of two series, means I have to go for coefficient of variation itself. Coefficient of variation is sigma divided by x bar into 100. So here however standard deviation comes. So last one is, it is well defined by a mathematical formula. That also true. Demerits means it is difficult to compute because it is a lengthier one, and you have to remember the formula also. It is the square root also. If it is square root of not, square root is not there, means your answer won't be correct. So it is difficult to compute. It is lengthier and time consuming also. Next one, it is affected by abnormal extreme values. If abnormal extreme values means or open end classes given, means we can't compute standard deviation, because we can't compute arithmetic mean. So that we can't compute this one also, which one, standard deviation. Next, which and all, next computation part. Computation, its relative measure is coefficient of variation, that is sigma divided by x bar into 100. Next computation part is there, for computation part which and all raw data is there, discrete series, continuous series. So that we will discuss in the next class. We will go to the problems also. Standard deviation problems are much important, so you have to be very clear with the concept and you have to study well. Thank you. We will continue in the next class.